Hi, it's Riana speaking from Liverpool Live TV, and I'm here with BAFTA and Emmy award-winning director Brian Percival. Welcome to The Fact.
Hello.
Hello. First things first, how does it feel to be back in Liverpool?
It's great, really good. I mean, it's you know, we've done a lot of publicity for this film all over the world, you know, all over America and then all over Europe, and it's just a nice way to end it, is to come back to Liverpool. And you know, we're out tomorrow night nationwide in England, and it's nice to do this event, particularly for Clapperboard, you know. So it's good, it's really good to be home.
And for those who don't know, do you mind telling us a little bit about what the film is all about?
Well, it's about human spirit and how sort of belief and the power of words that can allow someone to change their life, really. You know, it's incredibly positive story, which is set against quite a dark time, a dark period in history. It was Nazi Germany in the 30s and during the Second World War. And really, it's a story about a little girl who's been orphaned. She can't read, she can't write. She's sent to live with foster parents in a strange town. She's bullied at school. And in spite of all these sort of negative aspects in her life, she manages to take control of her life, and she manages to be the person she always wanted to be.
And how was it for you directing such a powerful film?
Well, the more powerful it is, the easier it is in a way, isn't it? Because if you've got a great script and you've got great actors, then it's easier in some ways to make a good watchable film. I think if the script's weak and you're not blessed with such good talent, then it makes it even harder. But you know, we did have a great script from the start. It's a great story. I think something like 8 million people have read the book. So we knew that there was an audience out there, an audience of people that would hopefully go and see the film. And it was just a joy, you know, complete joy to do it. Hard work, but it was good.
And what was it like working with the cast? Were they a good cast, willing to get
yeah,
down to
it? I mean, Jeffrey Rush is incredibly fun to work with, because he sort of, you know, quite often, in between takes, he clowns around. And sometimes if we're doing some very dark, powerful scenes, everybody needs that little lift in between, so that you know, everybody doesn't get dragged down into what can be a very powerful sort of emotional situation. And then on the other hand, Emily Watson, who you know, I've adored ever since I've seen Breaking the Waves. I mean, that was the film that made me want to direct. She stays in character all day, you know. So you're talking to it's quite a contrast between the two. And you know, they came along with. The children in the film, which are relative newcomers, you know, within the space of a few days rehearsal, we managed to knit them into this family group, which it's really, I think the younger actors had probably one of the best masterclasses in the world they could ever have. Emily Watson and Jeffrey Rush as your on-set tutors is a big help.
You spoke of some dark moments, and I'm quite a crier when it comes to films. Do you think the film will make me cry?
I'd hope so. It tends to be. It's ruined an awful lot of makeup all over the world so far, it is. There are quite some emotional moments in it. I sort of wouldn't deny that as well. So, but in a nice way, you know, because I think I always think it's great when I see films. The ones that take me on a journey, an emotional journey, are the ones that I connect with, and they're the ones that stay with me, and they're the ones that I want to see again. And so, you know, that was always an objective with this. So even though there are tears of sadness in it, there's also tears of joy. And you know, it hopefully will engage you on a whole spectrum of emotions. And if you cry, it might not just be because it's terribly sad.
Well, the emotion makes it all better, I think.
Good.
One question as well that I wanted to ask was, what was your personal favourite moment of shooting the entire film?
Oh gosh, I mean that's really quite tricky. I think there was just some, you know, there was some scenes. We did a book burning, which is quite a big set piece, and it took 5 nights to film it. And we were in a small town on the Polish border, and we'd had to teach 500 directors how to sing the German national anthem, because it was banned. It's been banned since the war. The words, the lyrics to it, they were banned, and also we had covered this square with swastikas, which was quite eerie to see that. We've seen it in books, and you know, but to actually stand in the square. And then as we were shooting this scene, I looked around, and I had 95% of the crew were German, and there was tears rolling down the cheeks of the German crew. And that was because, you know, the guilt that they felt from for what they believed their forefathers to be responsible for. And so I thought at that point it made me think, well, actually, if it's connected with ordinary German people and, you know, actually on set, then I think hopefully it will be quite moving when it comes to be seen by a wider audience. So that's probably one of the things that I'll sort of
take away,
stay with me. Yeah. But the hardest moment of all was trying to get Liesl and Rudy to kiss each other, because 13-year-olds do not want to do that, and particularly when they become best friends. So there's a scene in the film where they were directed to do that, and it was really tricky getting them to do.
I'm sure they'll remember that as well.
Probably. Not forgive me for it.
I think they will if the film will be a massive success. Oh. Clapperboard is here tonight, and how does it feel to be working with them?
It's great. You know, I've known Mo for so long, since I... You know, my wife and I did this short many years ago now called About a Girl, and Mo supported that, and she's always supported everything we've done. And I just think it's great that, you know, I noticed that in the film industry, you know, it's harder and harder to get a break these days, and it's harder and harder to get an education. And so it's not an easy industry to get into. And particularly, you know, if you've got a background that isn't privileged in any way. And thank heavens that there's people like Mo around and Clapperboard that allows people at least a way into that world, or a chance to know more about it, or to maybe get a start. And so everything she does is incredible, and I've been behind it since the start, so it's a real pleasure to come back and do this. You know, any way I can help is great.
Well, last question for me, and you spoke of opportunity, so do you have any advice to give out there to young directors wanting to break into the business?
I think, you know, you've really not got to give up. And if you believe strongly enough, it can happen. You know, I came from a modest background in Liverpool, and you know, brought up in Garston, lived in Speke until I was a teenager. And so, you know, I didn't know anybody in the film industry or anything about it. But it just became obvious that was something I wanted to do. And I think that determination and that will, if people can see, or youngsters in the industry can see that it can be done, then hopefully it'll make them go, well, you know, why not? Why can't I do it? He's done it, she's done it, so let me have a go. And so that's why I think it's important. I think it's important that they continue to believe and keep trying, and hopefully one day they'll get there.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
That's Riana Burton reporting for Liverpool Live. Thank you.